Extreme Mega Engineering. How China built a 15-story hotel in 6 days. Fast construction. China had traditionally been regarded as the world's top in all aspects. How is it not possible that it would be in a competing position? The achievements of the Chinese continue to amaze people. Former President Barack Obama draws clear comparisons between China's economic development and currency policies. China displayed a record of how a construction crew built the 15-story Ark Hotel in Changsha Province. This record demonstrates that China has experienced excellent economic success and the country's financial system is unlikely to have a significant role. Among the most amazing methods to spread any idea is to have a structure come out of nowhere in less than a week. China's Broad Group developed the Ark Hotel in Changsha in record time to highlight the speed and efficiency of their unique building methods. A crew of 200 people completed the 15-story interior structure in under 46.5 hours. External construction took another 90 hours for a total of less than 6 days. According to Broad, they want to construct 15 similar buildings in China and another 30 in other nations. Moreover, Broad claims speed as one of the Ark Hotel's benefits, but it isn't the only one. The Chinese company also wants to demonstrate that its constructions are superior in every way, for employees, the environment, and inhabitants. Broad says that its construction methods have been tested and can survive an earthquake with a Richter scale value of 9.0. If this is correct, the Ark Hotel is a significant structure. Even with the tight construction timetable, no employees were injured during the Ark's construction. The construction itself uses only 1/6 of the materials that would be needed in an equivalent 15-story building with 600 square meters each level, or 5,500 square feet. Building waste contributed for only 1% of total weight when rubbish created during the construction was removed. It's a soundproofed, thermally insulated structure. It was built entirely of steel or concrete by the construction team. In other words, a crew of off-site industrial workers manufactured the components while their on-site colleagues placed them on the Ark Project's foundation. Whatever the elements of the Ark Hotel and Broad Pavilion appeal to anyone, it's clear that China has come up with some creative techniques to improve its industrial infrastructure. None of these strategies are really unique, but Broad has brought them all together in one place and displayed them at rapid speed. Although speed may be a big attraction, it is believed that increases in efficiency and safety will have the biggest effect on people all around the world. Designers already have the resources to repair old buildings and make them more energy efficient. But projects like the Ark Hotel may be necessary to encourage developers to commit the cash required to explore these new types of construction. It will be exciting to see whether Broad can build 45 more of these products in China and abroad. As the world's population continues to expand rapidly, designers will require effective and efficient methods of generating additional residential and commercial areas. Broad's methods appear to be effective. Hopefully, they lead to advancements as valuable as their demos have been. While the speed of construction will surely bring this building technology to the attention of developers worldwide, however, the environmental features are the most impressive. Energy efficiency, material saving, and construction reduction of waste are all important if we are to create a stable human ecosystem in the future. The Broad Group and its quick building method initially gained international attention when they built a pavilion for the World Expo in Shanghai in 1 day. Lastly, the next significant concern is what miracles it will produce and how it will do it while dealing with such a large population. How will all of these shining structures help in future development planning throughout the world, and what will it mean for future generations and the Earth's ecosystem, which is slowly but steadily fading and degrading day by day? Above all, environmental protection is the next most important question in this area. So that was it for today's video. And if you find it useful, hit the like button. For more videos, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any updates from our channel.